So sixth problem we'll discuss quickly: market, nominal personal real accounts, opening stock, nominal purchases, nominal wages, nominal carriage, nominal rent and taxes, nominal commission, nominal bills receivable, real factory expenses, nominal oil and fuel, nominal motor van, real motor van, real trademarks, real account, debtors, personal account, cash, real account. Going to the credit balances, you have capital, personal account, creditors, personal account, reserve for bad and doubtful debts, consider them as nominal. Then sales nominal, purchase returns nominal, to be deducted from purchases. Moving on to the adjustments, closing stock, you will take it in the trading account credit side and balance sheet asset side. Next adjustment, depreciation on motor van 10%. So motor van is 4000, 10% comes to 400. You will be minusing depreciation of motor van from motor van and also taking depreciation on motor van in your P&L debit side. Next adjustment, reserve for bad and doubtful debts 5%. So it has nothing to do with the reserve and bad for doubtful debts given in trial balance. So if you see, once again, the reserve for bad and doubtful debts given in trial balance, we marked it as nominal. Being nominal, it has to come in P&L. If it is to come in P&L, the question arises in your mind, debit side or credit side? Naturally, credit side, because it is a credit balance. So a credit balance will go to credit side only if it is nominal account. Then next, so from debtors, you will minus this adjustment provision, which comes to around 400. So from debtors, you will minus provision 5%, which is 400, and take it again in the P&L account debit side as to provision for bad debts. Next, it is outstanding rent, which is outstanding expense. So what you will be doing as an outstanding rent, it is a personal account, so you will write it in balance sheet liability. Second effect, you will be adding it to rent in your P&L account. You will be adding it to your rent in your P&L account. In this problem, there is no rent directly given as such. Sorry, there is rent and taxes. That doesn't make an issue. So you can add to rent and taxes in your P&L account. The last item is prepaid taxes. Prepaid taxes, the same thing. It is prepaid expense. So write prepaid tax in balance sheet asset side and again minus this amount from rent and taxes in your P&L account.